See, the next topic we are going to see is about your homomorphic filtering. Okay. So previously we have seen some types of filtering which enhances the image by reducing the noise and by reducing the blurriness. Okay. So now by this class we are going to see about a very important filter which will be suitable for frequency domain. It's nothing but your homomorphic filtering. Okay. So what this homomorphic filtering will do is, okay, it is going the same as what we have discussed. It is going to be do some changes in the enhancement of your image. Okay. So how do they? What are the two components that makes your enhancement for an image? It should be specified under this topic. Okay. So take down. Homomorphic filtering. Homomorphic filtering. Is used to. Homomorphic filtering is used to improve the appearance of an image by simultaneous intensity range compression and contrast enhancement to be developed in frequency domain. Okay, you got that? You understand that? Okay. So this type of filter is to be do enhancement when the image is in terms of what? That spatial domain or in the frequency domain? It's to be do in the frequency domain. So obviously, what happened? The way done for enhancement is done by your simultaneous intensity as well as your contrast enhancement. Okay. So now this type of the image f of x is to be done with two components. One is with your illumination and another one is your reflectance. Okay. So that's why take on this derivation part. So f of x comma y. What is f of x comma y? Is that in representation of the image? Okay. So this f of x comma y is nothing but the product of two components. One is nothing but your illuminance component, which is termed as your I, and then the reflection component, which is termed as your R. So f of x comma y is equal to I x comma y into R x comma y. Have you taken down? Take down it. So and then I is in the range of 0 to infinity. R is in the range of 0 to 1. Okay. So obviously illumination is what? Light is to be emitted from a source. Okay. So that's why it is to be named as your illumination source. Okay. So when the light is to be illuminated from a source, obviously it will hit an object. Okay. So back from the object we get the reflected light. Okay. So that is your last case. R of x comma y is nothing but your reflectance of it. Okay. Take down. So reflectance is nothing but it is determined by the characteristics of an image object. Okay. Light from the object, that is to be called as your reflectance. Okay. Light from the source, it is to be called as your illumination. Okay. So this is normal how an image is to be represented in the function of f of x comma y is equal to product of I of x comma y and R of x comma y. Got it? So with this component only, what happened? We are going to do the functioning of your homomorphic filtering. Okay. So this is your general block diagram of how your homomorphic function is to be done. Okay, so take down the block diagram. So the very first one is, so totally here you will be having your five blocks. So the first one is applying a LAN function for your input image f of x comma y. Okay. And next one, applying your transform. Okay, discrete Fourier transform. And the next one, obviously once the Fourier transform is to be applied, the function will be changes from your trimmer version. Get it? So after applying your transform, the function is to take change in terms of your h of x function. Okay. So h of u comma v. Stand inside itself. Okay, and then what happened? Okay, what they are applying? They are applying your inverse filtering by applying your inverse function and then your exponential function. Okay. So the very first thing is f of x comma y. We know it is nothing but what? Product of what? Product of the answer to the question. Product of I into R. Okay, so once the LAN function is to be applied, so instead of x comma y, it is changed in the LAN function of x comma y. Okay, so the same thing, when you are applying LAN and log, what happened? LAN AB is equal to LAN A plus B. Okay, so the same thing, LAN I of x comma y plus LAN R of x comma y. So after applying this LAN transform, LAN function, we are changing it into your Fourier transform, which comes in the form of the representation of x will be turned into your frequency domain u and y is to be turned into your frequency domain v. Okay, so obviously the function will be changed in terms of your Fourier transform here. So instead of u comma v is equal to fi of u comma v plus fr of u comma v. Okay, so and then what happened? So again, okay, your transfer function h of u comma v is nothing but your product of h of u comma v into z of u comma v. Okay, so that's the representation only. Okay, clear? And next one, what is next block? They apply your inverse DFT. Okay, so in inverse DFT, what happened? The frequency domain will be changed into your time domain. Okay. So s of x comma y became as I dash of x comma y plus R dash of x comma y and last one in terms of exponential function. Okay. So this is just a filtering procedure to apply your transforms respective to your illumination of domain as well as your reflectance domain. Okay. Clear? Have you completed? Take from this. See, for this topic, that's a longer book, okay, because derivation has been given in a stepwise manner, okay. Right on. take writing, okay, listen. See, while doing DFT component, so what happens, your function has been split in the form of what? FIR u comma v plus FR of u comma v, okay. So that is the first thing they have given, okay. So actually your homomorphic function in terms of h of x comma y is nothing, f of x comma y is nothing but I of x comma y and R of x comma y. This is the actual component of your normal image, okay. But once your homomorphic filters will be applied, what happened? By doing your DFT transform, the component has been separated, okay. So in terms of FI of u comma v and FR of u comma v, okay. So that's what they are saying, the first step. And next one, how far the separation is to be done for your illumination component as well as your reflectance component, okay. So in illumination component, you will be having a slow variation of your image, whereas in reflectance components, you will be having changes to take place in a very fast manner, okay. Why? Because of it? Because illumination source is coming from where? It's coming from the source, okay. So obviously the changes over the light intensity from the source will be very slow than the reflector, okay. In a reflector like there will be an abrupt changes to be takes place than your illuminated source, okay. That's the second step, okay. So next one, by removing the low frequencies, the effect of illumination can be removed. So what is the way of removing your low frequency? What is the way of removing a low frequency? Obviously, by having your high pass filtering. That's all. Okay. So this is how they will be separated the component. Okay. Completed. Boys. Take on this graph. So this graph just show a function of distance between the pixels. Okay. D of u comma v. The distance between the pixel is frequency domain.
Low pass.
See, last class we have seen some problems with your median filtering. Okay. So students, those were absent on the last class. So please check with your friends. Okay. And the 2 week we have done a video on that day. I think so. For median filtering, we have taken video, right? Okay. So you can check with that. Okay. So now continue. Last one, I have given a problem. Have you all finished for the median? Do the problem. Do the problem for median filtering.
Place this value at candidate
the size of the image is analyzed. Okay, till the size of the image is analyzed. Okay, take down this problem. So this was the problem we have discussed in the last class. Okay, so take down the same problem. So apply median 3x3 filter on a given image f of x comma y. Use, so the first substitution is pixel replication for padding, and the second one is zero padding. Okay, so now we have to go for applying median filter. So one thing is for a replicated pixel, and another thing is for a zero padding. So what is size of an image given? What is size of an image? What is the given size of an image?
4x3.
It is a 4x4. So it is the size of a 4x4 image in the function of f of x comma y. Okay, so directly they have taken a pixel value for an image. Okay, so now before going for a median filtering uplink, first we should know what is your zero padding and what is your pixel replication. Okay, listen carefully. So what is the zero padding? So zero padding is nothing but adding of zeros. Okay, so the position where we are going to add the pixel value will throw it to be considered. Okay, so first we can see with your pixel replication. Okay, so I will say how the way the pixel is to be replicated. You just follow it. Okay, so start with solution. Rewrite the 4x4 matrix again. Rewrite the 4x4 given matrix again. So step one is we have to go for pixel replication. Step one another. Pixel replication. Okay. So now what is the fourth column? What is the fourth column? What are the values?
1, 4, 2, 6.
So replicated the same values to the near column. So make a fifth column. Other values like that now. The values in the fourth column. Do it. You have to make a fifth column same as that of the values in the fourth column. Done or not? So if you done to the fourth column, signally what happened? Signally what happened? Replicate the first column values to the near pixels. So again what happened? Make a value 4352. Do it. Puridha liya? Replicate means what? The values are 3 kilo kelvin in the form. Consent another column to the left. Obviously what happened? 4352. So now tell me what is the size of your matrix? 4 plus 6 are A, governing well, yeah. Listen first. The question is, apply a median 3x3 filter on a given image. Apply a median for a mask on the image. It should be in the size of 3x3. Okay. So the mask should be in the size of 3x3. Below to the right. Mask 3x3 and make empty 3x3 matrix. Construct an empty 3x3 matrix. So that is your mask. Because in the question they have given a mask of 3x3 to be applied. Okay. So this is your mask, which is a size of 3x3. See, listen. A mask 3x3. Since it is a median filtering, so obviously what happened? What is the center value of that mask? What is the center value of that mask? Mask for center value in a color. That middle value is your center, right? Amavar, yeah. So that's why you should highlight what is the middle term of your median filter. Okay. So now you have to take the 3x3 mask and you have to fix it in your replicated image. So this is your replicated image, okay? So you better put on the mask has been placed here. Imagine that a governing, I'm here to tell you, right? So a 3x3 mask is to be taken and it should be placed in your image. Okay, so obviously what happened? So first this is to be analyzed. Okay, now it is a 3x3 matrix. Okay, so now a median value should be assigned as 4. Now you should write the values. This is to be about the median value. So write it. In an value of there. There you go. 4. First you write the values in a row wise, okay? 4, 4, 3, 4, 4, 3, 3, 3, 1. Okay? Elements of the mass component is write it. Okay, yeah. Have you all written? Row wise up, I don't know. And the next step is arrange the elements in descending order. So descending order, rewrite it. So what happens? Totally 4, 4, 4, 3 and 1. Amava. Row wise are anything. So what is the middle value in that?
3.
What is the middle value?
3.
3, yeah. So circle that middle value. Then so now one part is to be analyzed. Okay. So I'll put it in a prano. Remove the mask and change it to the next position. So on again, I'm not thinking forward again. So when you have the component pull it down, this 4 becomes to where? 3. So other elements are in a row. 4, 3, 2, 4, 3, 2, 3, 1, 2. And what is the next step? Arrange it in a descending order. And find the middle value, circulate. Okay? Listen. See, the analysis is to be done till another size of the image to be analyzed. Okay? Governing. See, now we are going to continue with this. Okay? So now they have been shifted and come here. I'll look at now. Likewise, it will come across each and every column. Okay? Governing. So, in the middle value, what about the stop value? Okay, wow. So, in that sense, it will be very valid. Why? Because we don't have the next element. So obviously what happened? Key level will come. So yeah, so key level will come. This value will come. In a value set will come. When you take in this 3, what are the values? 4, 4, 3, 3, 3, 1, 5, 5, 1. And next what happened? Column wise analyze. After completing, next row. Okay, wow. So all the pixels are to be analyzed. completed. Last step, we have to change this actual duplicated image with the help of medium filtering. Let me check one more. The very first step. This fourth duplicate has got 3. So, even one more step, some changes can happen or the same element will come. So, end of the morning, the medium element will check. Completed. Completed.
Thank you.